this is Netra studying 6th standard reading today's news related to UPSC exams. Before going into the news, I request you all to subscribe our channel. Also like, share and comment my video.
Governance Digital Seva Setu Program. The Gujarat State Government launched the Digital Seva Setu Program for rural areas. It was launched under the BharatNet project of the central government. The villages will be connected with the 100 Mbps optical fiber network with an aim to make every village a mini Sachivalaya. It will provide 20 crore people services including the delivery of ration cards at doorstep.
Kritakyata Chief Minister of Assam Sarbananda Sonowal launched an online pension submission and tracking system Kritakyata, created on the lines of Babishaya portal of Government of India. Kritakyata is first portal of its kind among all the states in the country for their convenience of pensioners by expediting their pension related claims. Science and Technology Nobel Prize Physics 2020. The Nobel Prize 2020 in the physics category has been awarded to Roger Penrose, while the other half is jointly awarded to Anindra Ghez and Reinhard Genzel. The three scientists have been awarded the prestigious prize for their groundbreaking discoveries about the black holes. E-Learning Hub. The Indian Institute of Management, Kozhikode, will launch an e-learning hub and library as a pilot project for villages in Mavur under Unnat Bharat Abhiyan. The UBA is aimed at linking the higher education institutions with a set of at least 5 villages. This has to be done so that institutions can contribute to the economic and social development of the village communities using their knowledge base. ISLRTC and NCERT signed MOU. A memorandum of understanding was signed between Indian Sign Language Research and Training Center and NCERT in order to make education materials accessible for deaf children. The education materials would be available in their preferred format of communication. Society Time Use in India 2019. NSS report Time Use Survey, which was a first of its kind, was recently conducted by the Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation. The survey was conducted between January 2019 and December 2019. The primary objective of the survey is to measure the participation of men and women in paid and unpaid activities. It provides information on time spent in unpaid caregiving activities, voluntary work, unpaid domestic service producing activities of the household members. Survey also highlights the information on time spent on learning, socializing, leisure activities and self-care activities by the households. 38.2% of the population participates in employment and other related activities. They spend 429 minutes or 7 hours and 9 minutes each day. Only 18.4% women participate in employment activities when compared with 57.3% men. Women spend 299 minutes, that is almost 5 hours, on unpaid domestic services, which is thrice as much as men, 97 minutes or 1 hour 37 minutes. As per the survey, Indians do not like to be unpaid volunteers or trainees. Or to take part in community or organization-based unpaid volunteering. Only 2.4% of the respondents volunteer of such work. infrastructure. Animal bridges. Delhi-Mumbai expressway will have India's first 5 animal overpass or animal bridges with a combined length of over 2.5 km for safe passage of wildlife. These bridges are inspired from the wildlife crossing in the Netherlands. These will ensure no disturbance and no chance of any conflict to the Ratanambore Wildlife Corridor connecting Ratanambore and Mukundra Wildlife Sanctuaries in Rajasthan, as the wild animals will get such passage at every 500 meters interval. Atal Tunnel. Prime Minister inaugurated the Atal Tunnel, the world's longest highway tunnel at Rohtang. The 9.02 kilometers long tunnel, built at an altitude of 3000 meters, will connect Manali in Himachal Pradesh to Lahaul Spiti Valley throughout the year. Environment. Organic species seed parks. Gujarat to get country's first ever 2 organic spices seed parks at Patan Baskananda. It is for the production of cumin and fennel seeds. NABARD will provide grant assistance of INR 23 lakh to each of the parks. The 2 parks will create a complete value chain and will serve as a platform for captive use of organic seeds. Each park will cover 50 farmers and local FAO will operate the parks. My Ganga, My Dolphin. My Ganga, My Dolphin campaign was launched on the occasion of Ganga River Dolphin Day. This campaign was launched by the National Mission for Clean Ganga, the Wildlife Institute of India and the Forest Department. The campaign has been launched for sustainable tourism. It also links with the livelihood through dolphin conservation for ecotourism along the Ganga River. Dolphin Safari was started at 6 sites in the states of Uttar Pradesh, Bihar and West Bengal. Trained volunteers, being called as Ganga Praharis, will take the tourists on board for the Dolphin Safari. Arsenic affected habitations. The number of arsenic affected habitations in India has increased by 145% in the last 5 years. India had 1,800 arsenic affected habitations in 2015. This increased to 4,421 habitations as of September 2020. Most of the arsenic affected habitations lie in the Ganga and Brahmaputra alluvial plains, Assam, Bihar, West Bengal, Punjab and Uttar Pradesh. Assam had the highest share of such habitations, followed by West Bengal. Lantana, a special drive to uproot lantana bushes in the Sajangarh Wildlife Sanctuary was carried out. It is an invasive species which was introduced in tropical regions as an ornamental plant. It is native to Central and South America. Moruca diplostemon. This tree species, long believed extinct, has been rediscovered after a gap of more than 180 years from a scarred grove in Kollam district.
Sacred grove.
Moruca diplostemon. This tree species, long believed extinct, has been rediscovered after a gap of more than 180 years from a sacred grove in Kollam district.
Sacred grove.
Moruca diplostemon. This tree species, long believed extinct, has been rediscovered after a gap of more than 180 years from a sacred grove in Kollam district. Scientists at the Jawaharlal Nehru Tropical Botanic Garden and Research Institute at Palod have identified that tree as Mudhoka diplostoman, a threatened species of the Western Ghats, whose specimen was first collected in 1835. Only one mature tree has been found so far, which makes this remarkable rediscovery extremely valuable. The biodiversity map of Mumbai. The biodiversity map of Mumbai, made by Rohan Chakravarti, artist and cartoonist, in a first of its kind map on the rich flora and fauna of Mumbai. This map was created for the biodiversity by the Bay campaign initiated by the Ministry of Mumbai's Magic. New species of wetland plants in Western Ghats. Scientists of Aharhar Research Institute have discovered two new species of pipewort, a type of wetland plants in the areas along the Western Ghats in Maharashtra and Karnataka. The species found in Sindhudurg in Maharashtra is named Eriocallan parvipalam for its distinct minute inflorescence size, and the species found Kukma in Karnataka is named Eriocallan caravallans, indicating the Karavali coastal region in the state. Pipewort is a type of wetland plant. It belongs to genus Eriocallan. Some of the previously discovered plant species have medicinal values. They also have anti-inflammatory, antibacterial and anti-cancerous properties.
Thank you for watching my video. Today's PPT is given in the description box. Hope you all enjoyed our channel. Once again I repeat, please subscribe our channel. Also like, share and comment my video. See you tomorrow.